My first question, I must ask this. Are you still a book holder?
I'm still a book holder. I hold several books. I have two Gutenbergs. Yeah, and I still have the token, and I'm staking it, man. I'm all in, man. I'm in staking it on MinSwap.
I was thinking that all your focus is on meme tokens, on something like this, you know. And then I saw, oh my God, look at this token with utility, project with utility, and Deezy like this one.
Yeah, I mean, it's hard to not like it. It's hard to not like a crypto project that has a real business model and a real path to actual revenue, like, you know, tech industry revenue, not lemonade stand revenue.
What's your opinion about Mark Cuban? Is there any moment, what do you think, when Mark will be proud and tell to everybody?
Well, he is the outspoken.
I'm big investor here.
Yeah, he is the outspoken owner of the Dallas Mavericks, or was formerly. All right, here's my Mark Cuban take. All right, this is a little bit of a hot take here. You know, in America, we have a little bit of a frayed political system. You know, there's, I think most outsiders and, you know, a lot of the more aware insiders here in this country would probably say, yeah, we're captured by large industries. You know, both politicians are bought and paid for, both parties. You know, we can talk about individuals on another level, but I think Mark Cuban is signaling that he is going to try to run as a Democrat in 2028. He's signaling some, you know, he's getting more involved politically. He's speaking out in favor of DEI, which will put him, you know, firmly in the anointed camp of the left-wing politics here in my country. But I have a prediction. If he were to run in 2028, that is very, very expensive, very expensive. And one of the best ways to make money is through crypto and is through, you know, owning stocks, especially in the technology field. And so if he were to run in 2028, he might need some funds. And if he needs some funds, he might go all in on crypto in the next 12, 24 months and then pivot into something more serious, perfectly maybe timed with the bull market, and then make his exit. And then that's when he'll be, you know, the elderly statesman. But if that scenario plays out, he's going to have to pump his bags. And not a lot of people know he has a bag of book.
I love entertainment industry. I love that part of crypto industry. But tell me about your favorite narrative.
The favorite narrative in crypto right now is, you know, we have the AI hype that's happening right now. And underneath that, you have the D-Pin category. We had gaming was super hot. What are we looking at? 4 months ago. Gaming will come back sometime in the next 12 months. So to me, it's not what's the exciting narrative or what was exciting. It's what's not exciting today and what's going to get people, you know, hot and bothered, you know, a month or two from now. It's really, really tough. I mean, if anyone could perfectly predict it, they'd be a multi-billionaire and they would just be waking up on an island every single day. But I have some predictions for the next narrative. I think L2s and the strong projects in the L2s are going to be a hot narrative. I think Cardano is going to have its time. I think read to earn, you know, could be a hot narrative too. Read to earn is going to be nothing compared to AI or gaming. And so to me, if I really had to say, I think the next hot narrative is going to be L2 picks and shovels plays. Polygon, Avalanche, and Base, probably the three winners of the L2s.
Tell me your opinion about Bitcoin, magic number 100K.
Well, if you would ask me 6 months ago, I'd say, yeah, in 2025. Now 2024 is actually in the discussion. You know, I'm a big 4-year cycle guy, so I'm really big on tracking the halving, tracking tops, tracking bottoms, and then looking at the previous cycle, then using that as a predictor for the next cycle. And cycle after cycle after cycle, Bitcoin would top out 7 months after the halving. It did in 2020. Mostly, reach previous all-time high. So we had the halving in June 2020, and then it reached 20K in December. That was about 6 months later. The halving in 2016, we saw it reach the previous all-time high about 6-7 months later. Well, this time, we didn't hit all-time high, previous all-time high 6 months later. We did previous all-time high 1 month before the halving. So now we are 7-8 months ahead of schedule. And so to me, that's suggesting 100K in 2024 is leaning more likely than not.
Your message for all newbie in this space, what is the most important? Bitcoin
Dogcoins.
And education, or some investing in Dogecoin, or I don't know, memes?
I will say this, it's going to depend on the person, right? So everyone has different risk tolerance. If you're 17 years old and you're spending your money that you earn at McDonald's, you're going to have a much different strategy than if you have £500,000 in the bank and you're in your 60s and, you know, you're thinking about your retirement and you have a retirement set and you said, all right, you know, if I live this long, I spend this much money a year, I'm going to be good. But then inflation started eating away your savings. The government printed money and made your money worthless. You know, they're diluting the value of your money. And now you really, you know, you have a real conversation. But those two people are going to have different risk tolerance. The first guy, the teenager, if he wanted to put 20% of his net worth in Doge, I honestly wouldn't have too much to say against that. Unless he's like some rich kid or something, you know. But if it's a kid with $1,000 to his name, you know, including everything he has. And if he wanted to have $200 in Doge, that'd be fine. If you're a millionaire, you're 64 years old, and you want to put 20% of your net worth in Doge, I'm going to say you're smoking crack. Your grandkids need to take, you know, power of attorney. Something needs to happen here. You got a brain tumor. So it's going to be different for everybody. I think buying Bitcoin, though, is never a bad idea. Maybe if you buy the top, you're going to have to wait 4 or 5 years before you're in profit again. But you know what? You use that as a learning experience, and you buy the bottom. And you say, you know what? I bought at 50K. And then all of a sudden, Bitcoin drops to 30K. Maybe I buy some more. Oh, no, it dropped to 20K. You know what? Maybe I buy some more. Oh, my God, it's $16,000. That's about how low it went in America. Buy more. And, you know, that's the name of the game. So if you're down on your coin, oftentimes, as long as it's Bitcoin, oftentimes you just need to wait a few years.
Did you see a story about Dogecoin millionaire? He posted yesterday he's millionaire again. Because
I saw this morning.
He didn't give up. Yeah, just buy the dip, and now he's again millionaire. That's if you believe in project.
Well, besides Bitcoin, Cardano, I would say Doge is like a relatively safe 3 to 4x. Would you agree?
I don't know. I think book is that one.
But all right, someone is downloading Robinhood. They only can buy coins off Robinhood and they don't want to buy Bitcoin because of $70,000. I'm not mad if they say, you know, I'll put a little bit of money into Doge.
My opinion is if Doge make X3 from this level, from this stage, that means all industries is there where I expect my tokens and my coins.
Maybe. I mean, honestly, Doge is just a bellwether for retail. It's the canary in the coal mine. And so if you see Doge hitting all-time highs again, that's your signal that the cashier at the grocery store has $100 in crypto. And honestly, you know, maybe now is when you start taking profit.
Dizzy, thank you very much. It was a pleasure.
Yeah, man. Yeah, I want to thank you. Thank you for, you know, producing all this informative content about book. You know, I kind of leaned on your post at least a couple times on our live show. And so thank yourself for
that. That was the biggest moment. You made it possible. That was the biggest moment for my last few years story here when I saw that you use my content in your show. That's it.
Yeah. And I shared, you know, I didn't screenshot you and blur your name out or nothing, you know. Don't say like I stole your content or nothing.
No,
but yeah. I love expressing when there's good value-driven content creators out there. I like advertising the fact, and you're definitely a value-driven content creator. And if you're not subbing to this guy, you're making a huge mistake.
Thank you very much. It was a pleasure.
Hey, always a good time talking to you, man.